Salam detnachu would ye YouTube channel abyss watch. Pesi video ye. Dirimraka magua fatana, better roll later fatano bet. Tiago chuna, detail so chachon, abren island. Leguard new chachon video chun share in the Taraguna. Le YouTube channel lima disconachu, subscribe by Mark by Exio. Emlekako at this video chun access in the Taragura line. Honored the refet Tiago Chikabal. Hanan goes to the office every alternate day. And she went to the office yesterday. Which one best describes this one? A. Hanan goes to the office 5 times a week. B. Hanan goes to the office 3 times a week. C. Hanan doesn't go to the office on weekends. D. Hanan goes to the office 4 times a week. So for the given statement that Hanan goes to the office at alternative day. And yesterday, she went to office. So which one best describes this one? So the correct answer for this is choice B. This choice B, Hanan goes to the office 3 times a week is the best answer from the given alternative, which explains this, the given statement. When we say this, Hanan goes to the office every alternate day, which means she goes every other day in a week. We have 7 days, and if she goes every alternative day, she would go 3 times. That means day 1, day 3, and day 5. And possibly day 7, but since it's alternative, it would typically be 3 times a week. Therefore, that is the correct answer. And the other statement also mentioned, she went to the office yesterday, which aligns with the pattern of going every alternative day. Also. So the other one, we come to the options at A, C, and D. 5 times a week is too frequent for an alternative day schedule. And at C, there is no information about weekend in the given statement also. And at D, 4 times a week is not consistent with an alternative day schedule. So due to that, they are incorrect, and the correct answer is this one. Next, should sex determination tests during pregnancy be completely banned? A, no. People have the right to know about their unborn child. B, yes. It leads to indiscriminate female feticide and eventually will lead to social imbalance. C. Parents indulging in sex determination of their unborn child generally do so as they want to keep only a girl child. And D. Yes, people do not have the right to know about their unborn child. So which one best describes this statement? So the correct answer for this is B. This B is the correct answer. For the question, should sex determination tests during pregnancy be completely banned? The answer is yes. It leads to indiscriminate female feticide and eventually will lead to social imbalance. So that's the correct answer. So since this sex determination tests during pregnancy are often controversial because they can lead to sex selective abortion, particularly in a region where there is a cultural preference for male children. And this practice can result in significant gender imbalance as seen in some countries where the ratio of male to female has become skewed. And banning sex determination test is seen as a measure to prevent female feticide and maintain a balanced society. So due to that, this is the correct answer B. Other options, while people at A, while people may have the right to know about their unborn child, this right is often outweighed by the societal harm caused by sex selective abortions. And at C, this is incorrect because the issue is typically the opposite. Parents often prefer male children leading to female feticide. So at D, while this option, the idea at option D support the ban, it doesn't provide a strong rationale compared to social imbalance argument. So due to this, choice B is correct answer. Next, there are no dancers that are in slim and there are no singers that are in dancer. So which one best describes this statement? A, there is not one slim person that isn't a dancer. B, some singers are dancers. D, all dancers are slim singers. D, any slim person is also a singer. E, all singers are slim. So, which one best describes the given two statements? The correct answer is E. This is the correct answer. If we have the statement, there are no dancers that are in slim, and there are no singers that are in dancer, this means that all singers are slim. This shows all singers are slim. So, this there are no dancers that aren't slim, and this means that all dancers are slim. And at second, there are no singers that aren't dancer. That means all singers are dancer. So when we combine these two statements, since all singers are dancer and all dancers are slim, it follows that all singers are slim. And the option A, B, C, and D are incorrect. Since at A, this is not necessarily true because the statement doesn't say that all slim people are dancer at A. It doesn't explain that the statement all slim people are dancer, and at B, while this is true, it is not the best conclusion because the statement go further to say that all singers are dancer. And at C, this is incorrect also because the statement didn't say that all dancers are singers. And at D, this is also incorrect because the statement do not imply that all slim people are singers. So due to this, all are incorrect, and the correct statement is this one, all singers are slim. Other question, nowadays children are influenced more by their teachers. What does this mean? Or which of the following sentence align with this one? A large amount of children's time is spent in school. B, children consider teachers as their models. C, children consider teachers as their parents. D, technologies are influencing the children to follow their teacher. So which of this one best describe the given statement? So from this, the correct one is this, the statement at choice B, children consider teachers as their right model or their model. And this statement suggests that teachers have significant influence on children, and this is most likely because children often look up to their teachers as a role model or example to follow, which align with this the idea which is given at choice B. And the other options are less relevant or unsupported with the given statement. And when we come to A, while children spend a lot of time in school, this doesn't directly explain why teachers influence them more. And at C, children do not typically consider teachers as their parent, making this option unlikely false. And the other is, at D, there is no mention of technology in the statement. So due to this, this is irrelevant also. And the correct answer for this is this one. When we say children are influenced more by their teacher, this means that children consider teachers as their role model. The next, the government has announced a ban on the use of single-use plastic bag in all stores across the country. What does this mean? A, all stores will have to shut down as they will not be able to use plastic bag anymore. B, reusable bag create inconvenience for shopping. C, people will have to start carrying their own reusable bag when they go shopping. And D, the ban on single-use plastic bag will not have any impact on the environment. Okay, the best answer for this question is the choice at C. This one is the correct answer. People will have to start carrying their own reusable bag when they go shopping. This is the best. When we say this, the government has announced a ban on the use of single-use plastic bag in all stores across the country. This means that people will have to start carrying their own reusable bag when they go shopping. And when we say that, the ban on single-use plastic bags means that stores will no longer provide them, and so shoppers will need to bring their own reusable bags. And this is a logical consequence of the policy. And the other options are incorrect or unsupported. And when we say this, the idea on choice A, stores will not shut down. They will adopt by using alternative packing or encouraging reusable bag. And at B, while reusable bags might require some adjustment, the statement doesn't claim that they create inconvenience. And at D, the ban is intended to reduce plastic wastage
and improve the environment. So this option contradicts the purpose of the policy also. So due to that, these answers are incorrect, and the correct one is this C. And the next, recent studies show that some companies have announced that they would be laying off 500 employees due to financial difficulties. What or which of these the following explain this statement? A, the layer of employees were not performing well. B, the companies are struggling to stay afloat. But C, the companies are transforming their business plan. D, the remaining employees would receive a pay rise. So which one best describe this? And the correct answer for this is, or the statement which describes this, the given original statement is the sentence at B. When we say recent studies show that some companies have announced that they would be laying off 500 employees due to financial difficulties, that means that the companies are struggling to stay afloat. So this is the correct answer. And when I explained this one, the statement you mentioned that the layoff are due to financial difficulties, which imply that the companies are facing challenges in maintaining their financial stability, and this align with this the statement at choice B. And the other options are not supported or incorrect due to this, the reason that at A, there is no mention of employee performance being the reason for the layoff. And at C, there is no information about the companies transforming their business operation. And at D, there is no mention of pay rise for remaining employees at this the original sentence. Due to that, they are incorrect, and the correct one is the statement at choice B. Okay, this is the video I have in this part, and I will come with the next part in a short time. And until that, wait in touch with my channel, and don't forget to switch on bell button to receive notification when I upload new videos on my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this. Share the video for your friends, and don't forget to like as well as to subscribe my channel. Thank you.